الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. This is the chapter of remembering death. So remembering that we're going to leave this dunya and go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم actually said, أكثروا من ذكر هادم اللذات. يعني الموت. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, You need to remember the destroyer of all joys, of all delights of this dunya. You need to remember it much, actually. He says, أَكْثِرُوا مِن ذِكْرِ هَذِي مِن لَذَّانِ. Because when you think of, as any intelligent person, they think of the future. What is the objective of this life? What's the objective? Whatever you do now, there is something coming ahead. And the Prophet ﷺ said, the ultimate that all of us agreed upon, we're going to leave this life. We're going to finish it and go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you said, death will make everything looks insignificant. You know, if you got a problem, you're upset, you got a headache, whatever it is, and you see what happened to people when they die in all these countries, we see online, we see live even, the problem becomes smaller. And if you're happy and successful, death also will make you humble. Will not make you arrogant or full of yourself, which are things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't like. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reminding us as a believer to always work for after death. Yeah, he says, Al-Kayyis, the intelligent person, من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت. He always takes records, takes account of his own actions. He doesn't look at others. He doesn't see others. Subhanallah, shaitan will not make you see yourself in a bad shape. He always says, look at how he does. Look at how, yeah? He will never. And every ayah about Jannah, he makes you imagine yourself in Jannah. Every ayah about punishment, you will never imagine yourself in punishment. Watch yourself. You know, we talk about Jannah, you imagine yourself walking in the palaces. Talk about the hellfire, you see somebody else in the hellfire. And that is not true. The Prophet ﷺ said, the intelligent person takes record of his own self and all his action, he says, what will happen to it in front of Allah? What will Allah accept from me and reject from me? That's the whole purpose. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us ikhlas and sincerity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this life increase for us in every good deed and make our death pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make it the best day in our life. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all of us husn al-khatima and to give all of us the best place in dunya and the best place in akhira. Ask Allah to forgive us and forgive our parents, forgive our family and bless us and bless our families and protect us and protect our families. وَأَخِرْ دَعْوَانَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَجَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا.